What's up, everybody? We're gonna try some products today. We got WR Performance Products Total Wash Off-Road. It's supposed to be a straight spray and rinse kind of deal. Goes in your foam cannon. Then we're gonna try another one of their products. It's called Mud Defender. Mud Release Agent. It's spraying, shaying, and defend. And then on the seats, we're gonna use a little vinyl sauce to try to clean it up. As you can see, this unit is very dirty, faded, crusty, and dusty. The seats are pretty rough. So we're gonna see what this product will do. Maybe it'll be something good we can all use and enjoy. I'm gonna have to pre-rinse the bed. As you can see, some pretty thick dirt in there. So we wanna make sure we give this product the best chance it's got. Like I said, we'll do a little pre-rinse. Get all the big clumpy stuff off. And then after that, we're gonna mix it up and go from there. Let's see what we got. All right, as you can see, still dirty. Nothing special was done. Just knocked off some of the crud that was on it. Now we're going to take a little of this WR Performance product and we're going to try to do this so you can see that I ain't adding nothing. We're going to pour some of this in our foam cannon. Well, I don't know how I'm going to do this holding the camera. Let's try this. Off the top, I don't like how thin it is. Foam cannons usually has a texture to it. It's more of a liquid, but I don't ever mean nothing. And it says to add water to it. So if this will do that next. Pop end off the pressure washer here. Add a little water to it. And then we're gonna spray it on here and see what we come up with. We'll be back in just a minute.
So we're gonna do that now.
you can kind of actually see it pulling the dirt out of it. Kind of impressive. We're gonna see what it does overall. You can see it breaking the dirt loose from the plastic. Just got done rinsing it off. Overall, I'd say it did pretty good. I'm gonna see what it looks like when it dries. I know I got to do a little scrubbing on the seats because it's got a bunch of mildew and stuff on it, so that's gonna have to be scrubbed, but I think it did pretty good. And there's some spots that it struggled a little bit. But that was pretty bad right there. Later on, it'll probably be tomorrow because it's getting late now, I'm gonna video putting on the application of the mud defender and see what it does. Alright, we've got three what I call competitive sprays, and we got an old Polaris razor hood. I've got it sectioned off in three sections. We got three clean rags, so no product gets on either rag. We're going to test out the Maxima Sc1, which is one of my favorites. Then we're going to go to the Superior Products Coverall and the WR Mud Defender. What we're going to do is see which one applies the best shine, attracts the least dirt, and holds up the best. I think this SC1 here, some of everybody's favorite. We're going to start with it first on the right side. See SC1. Looks really good. That stuff smells really good too. Up next, we have the Coverall. This stuff smells really good too. It smells like baby powder. Notice the nozzle is a little different. So we're gonna apply the Coverall in the middle. It doesn't spray as strong as the SC1, but it also lays down pretty nice. Up next, we're going to try the WR Mud Defender. Oh, that lid's tight. All right. WR Mud Defender. This is going to go on the left side. I already don't like the way that sprays. That sprays really, really heavy. All right. Now, we're going to take our first rag. We're going to wipe the excess off of the SC1. I'm not really doing this part down here. We're mainly focused up here. So we're going to make sure there's no excess. If somebody can't be like, oh, you left a lot on there, it's going to stick. All right, there's your SC1. Up next, Coverall. Automatically, I notice it's a lot tackier. It's way tackier. And it's actually leaving like a oil. But, you know, as you can see it in the video. But we're going to make sure there's no residue. Because I'm going to throw dirt and everything else at this. See what sticks. And then we're going to clean it. And see which one holds up the best. That's your Coverall. Next up is your WR Mud Defender. It wipes off pretty good. It's really thin. And it also smells pretty good. Alright, now that they're all applied, the SC1 feels pretty smooth. Really no, there's not a lot of residue. The Coverall, it's a little, it's got a little bit to it. This one, I feel like this one's going to stick more. So what we're going to do next is we're going to take it and lay it down on the ground and throw a bunch of dirt and mud at it, then rinse it off to see which one comes the cleanest. All right, so first we're going to put some dry dirt on it, then I'm going to mix up some stuff and throw some mud on it. So let's see what this dry dirt does. Get it on there real good. Smear it all over the place. All right, we got dust stuck to it. So let's see what happens when we flip it over and knock it off. It looks like the Coverall is sticking the worst. All right, next, we're gonna do a mud. Cause that's what everybody does, they play in the mud. So we're just gonna put mud all over all of it. Let's make sure we get it on the SC1 so won't nobody say we didn't give it on the SC1. We'll smear it all in here real good. Let's rub it in. All right. Now everything's evenly coated with mud. We're gonna go see what it does on the rinse off. Now that we're back under light, as you can see, SC1 beading water nicely. Very good bead, still has it shine. The Coverall, it's sort of beading the water, got a little streaks in it. It's not as shiny as the SC1 steel. The WR mud defender, it's not beading water. And it's already lost all of its shine. I'm gonna let it completely dry. Then after it dries, I'm gonna peel the tape so we can see the difference. Because nothing under the tape here is treated. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna put air against it and see how good the water beads on it. This is the SC1. As you can see, it's beading water nicely. This is the Coverall. There's no shine left on the Coverall. Look at the water running off the SC1 from the Coverall. And this will be the WR mud defender. There's nothing left. So that's pretty much dry here. As you can see, that's SC1. I'm gonna say SC1 for the win. All right, here's the final results now that we're pretty much mainly dry. WR mud defender. I can still feel a little bit of sheen to it, but it lost all of its gloss. The Coverall, it's a hard call between the two, really. But the SC1, SC1 for the win, man. I mean, it kept its gloss, it's still there. I'm gonna say SC1 for the win. The SC1 held less dirt. It rinsed off quicker. The Coverall attracted more dirt. Mud Defender come in second on attracting dirt. But overall, I'm gonna say this is the winner. SC1 high gloss coating. So, yeah, there's a true side by side comparison. SC1. The Coverall and the Mud Defender. I mean, you can see a touch bit more sheen on the Mud Defender, but it's not much. But for the price, they're all about equally priced. I'm definitely going with the SC1. And one more thing, let's get a good up close. Like where the SC1 is, everybody's like, oh, there's still a lot of product on there. No, it's on there. As you can see, I mean, I'm rubbing it. And it's like, if I'd have let that sit there and soak for a while, I'm pretty sure it would have come out a lot different. But yeah, that's good stuff.